today we've got a newer tutorial for you, obviously, which hopefully, as you can tell, is supposed to be snowman, sort of magical snowman with 3D elements and glitter. It's actually quite easy to do, so let's get started. The base color I used, as you can probably tell, is a very, very pale shade, so the first part of the tutorial is going to be quite difficult to see. But it'll get better once I start adding actual color to the white, which is completely invisible against the shininess. The base color I used is Luminescent by Color Club, Luminescent. They actually put the ice part in the word in capitals, which I thought was pretty funny. But anyway, I just started out the snowman as white blobs and then started to add detail with dark blue. There's probably some sort of like official term for this technique, but it's basically just dragging the blue inwards. Then adding some more white and adding some more blue, mixing it all together, and then it sort of starts to look as if the snowman is actually in 3D rather than flat. I think it looked pretty cool, and it just is one of those things that's really, really, really easy to do. Yet it makes the entire thing look way more intricate and way more artsy, I guess. So yeah, that's really the sort of thing that I like. One other thing, with making it more, you know, making it look more detailed, more professional almost, I hope, is to make the, like, well, actually this particular snowman is frontal view, but the other two are more, I think it's called dynamic. I'm really trying to remember what all those terms were we learned in high school in art class. I was never very good at it, I just picked it because it was an easy subject. But anyway, yeah, I think it was called dynamic, so when something is not frontal or in profile, I guess, but sort of like something between those things, then it's more dynamic, it looks as if it's moving, as if it's more realistic, and it just makes it look better. And it's actually, especially with snowmen, it's quite easy to do simply because they're just snowmen, like they don't have hands, they don't have legs, they just have balls of snow, and that just makes up their entire body, obviously. So I think snowmen are actually a very good way to practice painting as well, because they don't have a lot of detail by nature. On the other two nails, by the way, the nails that didn't get a snowman on it, I painted a snow crystal instead. This is also getting blue paint, but not to make it look more 3D, but just to give it more, you know, more of an intricate look. More of an interesting look with the colors mixed together. And then I just started to paint all the details on the snowman. I actually kept them quite simple, but I wanted them to look nice and fancy, so they did get a top hat and a Christmas colored scarf. They all look exactly the same in terms of their clothing. But yeah, it's just how I like my snowman. Actually, in fact, I don't actually ever make snowmen because I live in the Netherlands and we don't really get much proper snow here. Like, we do get cold weather, but it's just a sort of snow that's like, it sort of half melts when it hits the ground and then it just gets all cold and soggy and, you know, not the sort of snow that you can actually do anything with. Actually, fun story. Well, not so fun when it happened, but like one time when I went to work and it was snowing, it was a few years ago, then we actually, like, you know, I work as a postman, so we have to go somewhere to pick up the mail and then obviously start our working day actually delivering that mail. I had put on my snow boots and I jumped off my bike when we reached the point where we had to pick up our mail, right into a pile of the soggy snow, and that's how I found out that my old snow boots weren't waterproof anymore. And because I was too lazy to go back home to redress, I just did my entire working day with soggy cold frozen socks, which was fun. Not strangely enough, I didn't get a cold, I didn't get frostbite, so it was all fine, but still it was sort of uncomfortable. And then I proceeded to buy new snow boots, and then it proceeded to not snow again for years, so my new snow boots are still gathering dust. But yeah, at least if it will ever snow again, we'll have, you know, proper snow boots here. Yeah. That sort of thing in the Netherlands. Like, I always keep hoping for, like, a white Christmas and, like, snowy winter. We never really get it. But yeah, maybe someday. And I'll probably regret it anyway, because I'll have to work outside in it. And it'll probably get slippery, but still. But yeah, enough of complaining. At least I can paint snowmen on my nails. I think the last time I actually did make a snowman in real life, I think it was back when I was still in high school. That thought really makes me feel old, because it means that it's about 10 years ago. I'm 25 now, so I was probably about 15, so that's 10 years ago, a whole decade. Jeez, I feel old now. But yeah, then there was actually, well, there wasn't a lot of snow. There was just a little bit of snow, but it was actually decent snow that time. And I sort of made a snow, not a snowman, because there wasn't enough snow for that. But sort of a snow teddy bear, which quite frankly looked absolutely terrifying. And it wasn't cute at all. And it was nightmare fuel. But yeah, anyway, it was fun to do nevertheless. But yeah, actually back to the painting for a second. Some more things to really make a painting on the nails look more intricate is just by adding really simple details. Like, it's really no effort to add stripes onto the scarf. But it just makes the entire thing look way more detailed, way more complicated almost, and just way more lively, I guess. Yeah, I guess that's the word for it, more lively, just because there's more going on in there. And one other thing, like I already did on the top hat here, is to add actual white shininess to things that are supposed to be shiny, just like the eyes of the snowman. And I think that's also an important thing overall, to add glossiness to eyes, because anything is supposed to look like a creature. Just sort of looks dead when there's really no glossiness to the eyes, so I think that's a very important thing. It's actually something I didn't realize at first until I realized that all my creatures on my nails looked sort of creepy, and I realized it was because they all had completely dead eyes. So yeah, that's quite an important thing, I think. Also, I was thinking, there's a lot of horror stories and horror movies about snowmen coming to life, but I've never seen a horror movie about the life of a snowman. Even though, actually, like, of course, if I would see a live snowman walking towards me, I would scream and run, like any sane person probably would. But I think it's much more creepy to think of being an actual snowman, because you're just standing there, like, assuming, like, laws of physics don't work at all, you could actually maybe be able to walk, even though you don't have muscles and all. But otherwise, you know, you just know that at some point, you know, it's going to stop freezing and you're going to melt, and it just seems like a very terrifying life to be a snowman. But yeah, anyway, if there is a horror movie about it, I'd love to hear about it, because it seems like quite an interesting thing. But yeah, anyway, back to the actual painting. I'm also adding an outline. I wasn't actually planning on doing an outline at first, but then I realized that, you know, against the blue backdrop, blue-ish snowmen don't really stand out all that much, so from a distance it just looked like random floating pieces of clothing and dots. So that wasn't really what I was going for. So I decided to add an outline anyway, which is quite frankly the most terrifying part of any nail art, adding an outline. Like, it's absolutely terrifying, especially when doing it on a snowman, because I'm adding a black outline to a mostly bluish white thing, and yeah, any mistakes are going to be near impossible to fix. What really helps me is to make my brush as thin as possible. I actually looked up a tutorial quite a while back. It was by Hot Pink Zebra Polish. It was a really, really, really good tutorial. If you do nail art as well, I really recommend checking it out, because she really explained how to properly chop down a brush. So make it way, way thinner. Basically, it's just a matter of keeping the, you know, the inner bristles of the brush. And that just makes it a lot thinner, as you can see. Like, this brush is edited as well, and it just makes it so much easier to do details and to do an outline as such. Because obviously, if the brush is really thin, you won't be able to make, well, you won't easily be able, I'm quite sure I could manage it, but it won't be easy to make lines that are way too thick. So it really, really, really helps with details, with outlines, just with most parts of this type of nail art. And yeah, once the acrylic paint was dry, do wait for the acrylic paint to dry, because otherwise, you know, you might smear it accidentally. But then I started adding the 3D items. So first off, I added some regular nail top coats to the tips, then added some loose glitter on top of it with a nail art fan brush. And then I just sort of pressed it on there with my fingers as well, to just make sure that everything lies as flat as possible. Then on the nail where the snowman is sort of looking up, I just added a few flatback rhinestones, flatback pearls really, which are supposed to be snowflakes, and then some tinier snowflakes which are made up by caviar beads. I do actually recommend just dipping the dotting tool or the wax pencil in the top coat and then grabbing the caviar beads, because picking them up with a wax pencil proved to be near impossible and very frustrating. And this type of wax pencil that I'm using is just a very cheap one. I think I got it either off eBay or Born Pretty store, and you can just sharpen it so the top coat is very easy to take off again. And then on the icicles, I pointedly didn't actually outline these, because I wanted them to stand out less than the snowman, obviously. But they did get rhinestones. They got a glittery rhinestone at the center and then a regular tiny rhinestone on each of the legs. Just to give it a little bit more bling. And then the center snowman got some bling in his eyeballs as well, just to give them some more shininess. And then after that, it was time for top coat, but I wanted something even more magical and special, so I didn't add top coat, I actually added fairy dust by China Glaze, which, as you can see, is a clear base with holographic glitter in it, just some sparse glitter. I think it just really gives the entire look something extra, you know, something extra glittery, like a glittery magical snowstorm. Yeah, I just really liked it. I did try to go around the big pearl thingies because I didn't want to have glitter all over them. And yeah, I just think it sort of just pulled the entire look apart. I also applied it on the two icicle nails, and that's actually the final step of the tutorial. And here we have the final result, and I really, really had a lot of fun painting this. I just, for some reason, absolutely love painting snowmen. Mostly because they're actually quite easy, but they can also be made to look quite intricate, and they're just a lot of fun to paint. I hope you enjoyed watching this. If you did, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to, you can also subscribe to my channel. I actually do nail art videos once per week. Once per week I do a makeup tutorial, and then once per week I do a random video, which can be a piercing video, or a DIY, or tag, or whatever else I can think of. For now, at any rate, thank you very much for watching this video, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!